Prime Minister, you've been in the news quite a bit lately, and about this coronavirus crisis that we're in. There are a lot of residents in Curaçao that only speak English. What would you like to say to them?
Well, first of all, I want to thank you for being here, for being present also in our daily press briefings, and the fact that you can communicate, because although we try to translate our information in different languages, we're still bringing it up to par. And of course, giving the live press briefing is difficult to translate immediately in different languages, so we appreciate that. And for our local community, but also those that are following you worldwide, it is a new, it's a new life. It's a new reality, not only here, but in Curaçao, and we were not excluded, even though we live on an island. We had to take our measures in order to protect, first of all, the livelihoods, the healthcare, the health, and lives of our own people. And because of that, we had to take some drastic measures. First of all, closing the borders with Europe, and then a couple of days after that, closing the borders with other countries. This is not because we are disconnected from the world, it's because we are, in fact, connected in what is now known as flattening the curve. We have to take our responsibility for the health of our people, but we also have a responsibility to stop the spreading here on our island, but also worldwide. And we do that with utmost care and concern for our community. We know that these have consequences with regard to our way of life. We are social people, we like meeting each other, we like hugging each other, we like going to restaurants, and that as of now has changed dramatically. And we also have to prepare for what's coming after: job losses, economic challenges, social challenges. Fortunately, I can say that we are preparing measures for that, and we had a good conversations also with our kingdom partners, Aruba, Saint Martin, and the Netherlands, where we agreed that this is a extraordinary, challenging situation for all of us, and that the circumstances require other approaches and other ways of working together. And in the coming weeks, we will detail how we can support each other within the kingdom. So it is difficult, but the only way to get through this situation together is together, is by carrying our own responsibility, taking care of our own health, our own hygiene, eating healthy, taking our vitamins, but also the part of taking care of each other, maintaining distance. And it's a bit contradictory, because we are a community that lives close together, but we need to remain distant from each other in order to care for each other. And that is something that we took that measure also early, so we can take some days to get accustomed. But we need to maintain that discipline. It counts for us as well. But I am encouraged by the way we are supported by the community, even though it is affecting our lives. The government is supported in the measures that is taken. We are receiving a lot of feedback and are encouraged also by many volunteers, many businesses that are offering to help, individuals that are offering to help other people for free. And this is exactly what we need at this time. So it's a coming together. We have to show our resilience, and we need to keep faith and determination to survive, but also to thrive after this.